Join us on a road trip as we explore Wisconsin's curbside eats.
Hello and welcome to Discover Wisconsin.
This is an anthem for those who look for more and never say they've seen it all. Windows and blinds, take a ride. The Dairyland's great tonight.
This episode of Discover Wisconsin, America's Dairyland, is brought to you by the Dairy Farm Families of Wisconsin, the Wisconsin Milk Marketing Board. America's Dairyland is my land.
From tacos to shrimp and grits to grilled cheese and everything in between, food carts and trucks make the most of what Wisconsin has to offer. Today, we're checking out a few.
In many urban areas throughout the state, food trucks are common sights where you can pick up a great meal or even a quick snack. With an abundance of tasty offerings, it's no wonder these mobile restaurants are so popular. Heading over to Milwaukee, we decided to meet up with the Gouda girls. These gals offer up authentic Wisconsin grilled cheese sandwiches, and we were curious to see how they prep for a day on the road.
All right, Tina, so we're slicing cheese?
Yes.
And we're assembling sandwiches that you're gonna grill on the truck?
Yes.
For lunch here. How much prep work do you have to do? How much do we have to slice?
Normally when I slice my cheese, I'll do it all at one time. I will go through and slice, oh my goodness, probably 50, 60 pounds of cheese every week.
50, 60 pounds?
50, 60 pounds every week. Our top seller on the truck right now is our triple, and that's a beautiful blend of Havarti, Gouda, and a Kojak. And every day I probably make between 30 and 40 of those sandwiches every single day. Our newest sandwich, the Havarti Hottie, which is Havarti, which is the one we'll be assembling. Oh, I usually have between 20 and 30 of these on the truck. And I will come home, 9 times out of 10, I will sell out of the sandwich on the truck.
How many cheeses do you work with?
On an average, I think I have anywhere from 11 to 12 different flavors of cheeses in the truck because I want to showcase what Nobleview does. And you can get cheddar or Swiss anywhere. I want to offer the habanero pepper jack. I want to offer the chipotle cheddar. I want to offer these cheeses that are just way out there.
All right, so we sliced up all the cheese.
All righty, now should we assemble one of these bad boys so you can see what's all in there?
Let's do that.
Fantastic. We take two slices, and I stagger it, because I mean, you gotta get full cheese coverage, for goodness sakes. And then we'll take a piece of that habanero pepper jack. And then, honestly, the bacon varies. I personally like a lot of bacon on the sandwiches.
The more bacon, the better.
Exactly.
Just like the more cheese, the better.
Exactly. It's all about the cheese.
It's all about the cheese, and it's all about more cheese.
And then we go and put another slice of that habanero pepper jack on. And then, just because I'm a little anal for aesthetics, I like to swap my cheese around so it full
so
coverage.
So we have 6 slices of cheese on this sandwich.
And I weighed it out one time, and it's just shy of 7 ounces.
All right, well now I get to find out how we grill this thing. Let's get to the truck.
After all that prep, it's time to load the truck, head downtown, and start taking orders.
Ah, here it is. Very good. Hey,
Tina, here.
What you got?
Wisconsin cheesesteak.
Oh, no. You gotta try my mac and cheese.
Oh, no. At least our Havarti Hottie. There is 7 ounces of cheese on that sandwich.
Oh, no. If you're gonna have cheese, though, you gotta have creamy tomato soup.
That sounds good. Can I do all of the above?
You can get all of it.
Oh, come on. Let's have it. Let's fill your tummy. Yes.
Time to hop in and help the Gouda girls make some ooey gooey cheese sandwiches.
So,
that's a lot of time.
This is what we call our Wisconsin cheesesteak. And we always serve it with a fork and about 3 napkins.
A fork and 3 napkins.
Yep.
Might as well make myself useful and help deliver this cheesy goodness to the customer.
Hey. Now for your main course.
Appreciate it.
Check that out, huh?
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Anything else I can get for you?
No, I think it's all good.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
The customers kept on coming and ordering. Tina kept on cooking, and Catherine kept on serving up her signature sweetness and some mighty fine food.
The Havarti Hottie is the best seller right now. That and the cheesesteak.
I'll take one of those.
You want the Havarti Hottie? All right. $5.75, honey.
No matter what you order off the Gouda Girls truck, you can rest assured that it's made fresh with local Wisconsin cheese and definitely seasoned with lots of love. Want to catch up with the Gouda girls? Then head to our website and download a list of links to find out where you can find their truck. Our road trip continues with Mariah making a Norwegian burrito while I whip up a gourmet poutine. Stay tuned.
Welcome back to America's Dairyland, where Eric and I are discovering some tasty curbside eats. We continue our heavenly food truck tour by stopping at a little hidden gem on our way through Sturgeon Bay. Nista means takeaway lunch in Norwegian, and that's fitting for this mobile restaurant we found tucked away in an obscure spot.
We found Nista Box in the cutest alley I think I've ever seen. We have heard so much about the menu here.
Yeah, we feature what we call North by North Mex cuisine. I'm from Southern Door County. My husband is from Norway, and we love Mexican food. So we try to use products that are from the community here.
Well, I'm starving. What should I order here?
The Sturgeon Bueno. It is a smaller version of our crockpot pork burrito, but it also features two different cheeses from Renard's. It has the pepper jack and the one-year cheddar. So if you want to be a little indulgent on the dairy side. We also have the Ole and Lina burrito, which is a little holler back to Norway, Marcus's home country. It is Norwegian meatball patty with a tittebar crema in it and cabbage.
Charlotte and her husband Marcus started the food truck as a way to live in Door County seasonally. Since opening on a rainy evening in 2013, this little Norwegian ray of sun has been shining ever since. In fact, one customer was quoted as saying, "The best burrito is apparently made by a Norwegian guy in a food truck in Wisconsin." Well, I had to see what that was all about, so I headed to the truck for a lesson from Marcus.
So we can just start off by just placing both on the plates, mm-hmm. and then use both the cheeses.
Both cheeses.
Cool. So we have the pepper jack from Renard's.
Okay.
And we have, there you go.
Is that enough? Do I need more?
And then a good
chunk of the
ooh. Cheddar cheese.
Oh,
awesome.
Yeah. I like the cheddar.
Yeah, the okay. 1 year cheddar. And then we're just gonna place this on the grill.
Melted cheese loaded with slow-cooked pork and garnished with homemade beans, pickled red onions, and of course sour cream flavored with Norwegian lingonberries.
One sturgeon bueno for Will.
Alrighty.
I did not skimp on those ingredients, so enjoy.
Well, become a...
All right.
Good
high
job.
That was pretty easy.
If you're a fan of Mexican food, you should seek out the Nista Box. It doesn't disappoint. Another place that won't disappoint is on the 400 block in Wausau, where Eric found another taste bud worthy place to dine.
You might be surprised at what you find at some of these food trucks. Today we're going gourmet at Urban Street Bistro. Clint Schultz's food truck was born out of a desire to bring thoughtfully prepared, locally sourced cuisine to the streets by elevating ordinary street food.
We don't have a static menu. Our menu is always changing. Rarely some things we've ever done twice. A lot of people say, that was great. I'll be like, great, because we might never make it again. I love that. I love working with the seasonal stuff.
His philosophy is to tweak the food that people want and take it to the next level with taste and presentation. For example, their hot-selling version of poutine.
Perfect.
All right.
Get a good salt and pepper, yep. Doing these little toss
like
moves
that
so everybody gets some.
So now we put them in here?
Yep, put them in your boat.
Overflowing with fries. Check that out.
That's the way it should be.
Next up, curds, right?
You gotta have curds.
All right. Set. Timer. All right, so a good handful of curds.
Yep, no,
fresh
a good
curds.
Handful.
All right.
Probably another one even, right?
Yeah, I think a little more. Let's be generous.
Yep. You gotta hit it with some gravy.
Gravy time. All right.
We got a savory pork gravy on there.
Wow, look at how thick this is.
It's good, right. Good, Lionel. We like to joke that this is salad's evil twin.
Decadent it is, but right. We're not done, are we?
No, let's garnish it up. We gotta make it food truck worthy.
Gotta garnish this up now. We go yep. with a little sour cream.
Yep, we like to say Bob Ross it. Just paint some sour cream in there. A little fresh green onion.
Some fresh green onion, top it off.
Right.
How's that?
Looks good enough to eat, huh? I have to tell you, I sampled it and it was truly decadent. And so is the shrimp over three cheese grits and the Wisconsin brie and grilled chicken sandwich. Trust me, you want restaurant quality street food? Then make this truck stop a priority. Log on to discoverwisconsin.com and plan your food truck adventure by downloading an interactive map of all the places we visited. Don't go away, we're only halfway through our road trip. Stay tuned. Welcome back to America's Dairyland, where we're discovering delicious curbside eats.
We've been to food trucks and food carts all over the state. Now we're bringing it to the Capitol Square and the Taste of Madison for one of Wisconsin's most iconic foods, fried cheese curds.
Hi there, welcome to Curd Girl.
Hi, good to be here.
You know we couldn't do a food truck show without highlighting one of our state's most beloved foods.
It's a Wisconsin tradition, you know, it's something that's unique to Wisconsin, and so we have visitors all the time from other states, from other countries come, and they know that they have to try cheese curds when they're here in Wisconsin.
Curd Girl's food cart cooks up some of the finest curds around, and I got the chance to pick up a few of their secrets.
This is quite a bit of guilty fun here. So these are lightly coated,
yeah,
with the batter.
They look great. They look like they're ready to head for the fryer.
Sounds good to me.
So these curds are ready for the fryer. So you're gonna take your tongs. We're gonna first drop the basket into the oil. And then you're gonna carefully drop them individually, tong them into the oil.
Just like that?
There you go, just like that.
Okay.
Kind of give it a shake to make sure they're not sticking together.
Okay. Now how long do we cook
these
for?
So that looks good. We're gonna give them about a minute longer.
Okay.
So when they're done, they start floating to the top. You can kind of see the color through the oil. It's working, the magic is happening.
Oh, man. Some of them are sticking together. Okay.
And now let's pull that basket out.
Yeah, those are looking awfully golden.
Fried golden brown, piping hot, and served with homemade dipping sauces, these curds scream Wisconsin pride. But be ready for a long line. They're rather popular.
Man, I helped make these. You'd think I'd get special treatment or something.
Well, no such luck for me. I hope Mariah has shorter lines where she's headed.
Bummer for you, Eric, but rest assured, I was a captive audience at Gordo's food truck before it opened. George and Jessica Ortiz serve up authentic Mexican cuisine all over the city of Eau Claire. One of their specialties is a bite-sized cheese quesadilla.
There's nothing like a melted cheese in your burrito or like just a gooey, you know, quesadilla, you know, and we like to tell people that sometimes the quesadilla is the Mexican cousin of a grilled cheese because it's so gooey and stringy and just like a grilled cheese sandwich is.
Before they opened to the public, I was fortunate enough to learn how to make these authentic Wisconsin cheese quesadillas.
All right, George, tengo hambre.
You're hungry?
You make a quesadilla?
You want to make a quesadilla?
Play a couple
All
quesadillas.
Right. Yeah, let's do a few.
We are hungry.
They're probably the easiest and fastest thing to make. So.
All right.
So then we just place them on the hot...
Does it matter if it's this way or that way?
No, it doesn't matter.
Okay.
All right, so then we grab cheese.
My favorite part.
Yep, a nice little pinch.
Nice little pinch,
like
that.
Bigger than that.
More cheese?
Yeah, more cheese.
More cheese, he says.
More cheese, the better.
I like George. More cheese, the better, that's
yes,
true.
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
The cheese starts to melt, then that's when you do the magic.
That's when the
real magic happens. Once you flip it, oh, that beautiful toasted cheese.
The toasted cheese, it's crispy. Yeah. That is my favorite part. It is kind of like a grilled cheese in a way. All right, George, moment of truth.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be good? Mmm. Really good.
Crust is really good, isn't
it? Crust is super good. The crispy cheese is the best part.
Yeah.
For sure.
Yeah, definitely. Mm.
If you're in the Eau Claire area, make a plan to stop by Gordo's for some authentic tacos, burritos, quesadillas, and other Wisconsin cheese-laden Mexican fare. Want to find out where these trucks are headed? Then log on to discoverwisconsin.com and download a map of locations, Facebook pages, and Twitter handles. Up next.
Oh, man.
It's not good till you're licking it off your elbow.
I'm literally up to my elbows in this burger.
Oh, Eric. Stay tuned.
Did you want that to go?
We're back in America's Dairyland, road testing some great curbside eats. Most of the places we've stopped in have been rather large cities, but smaller towns enjoy food truck fare as well. And we were lucky enough to find one up north in Phillips. Lola's Lunchbox features made-to-order food using locally sourced products. This tiny food cart churns out food loaded with fresh dairy ingredients and lots of spices.
Food should be an experience of flavor and texture and juiciness and sweet and savory and just so many layers instead of just a one-note type of flavor.
Trust me, the flavors are as good as the smells, and I couldn't wait to get my hands on one of those burgers.
Is that one mine? How about that one?
Not yet. Good taste come to those who wait.
Customers can order by text, Facebook, or simply stop in and step up to the window. However, most of them are simply lured in by the great smells wafting from the grill.
I think that really draws you in. You drive by and you can smell it versus, you know, a restaurant, you gotta walk inside. Here you just gotta drive by and smell it.
So this is the popper burger. This is like a jalapeno popper spread, right?
Yes.
So you grill it with that on there so it gets melty.
So it gets nice and melty. And then we actually put it under a blanket of four cheeses.
And that gets melty?
Yep. And I'll let you do the honors. A little zhuzh of water squirted under there. That'll help. Oh.
More?
Atta baby. All right, there we go. Steam that up. And that'll heat the cream cheese. It'll heat all the other. It'll create a nice cheesy blanket around the burger.
Judging by how busy they were, people craved Lola's tasty offerings.
Behold the popper burger.
All this melty, cheesy goodness. There you go. Thank you for your assistance.
My pleasure. Because now I get to eat it. Right? It's already dripping out the sides. I may want to wait a minute.
It's a little steamy.
It's a little steamy. Shall I go for it?
It's not good till you're licking it off your elbow.
You'll have to check out a bonus clip to see if I was really up to my elbows. But down in Schulzburg, Mariah's flexing some muscle to help out another food truck.
That's right, Eric. Aside from helping deliver food, I helped slice a wedge of cheese for the lunch bus crew.
Here's your cheese.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Amy Poole owns the lunch bus along with Tiffany Donahue. After working several years in the corporate world, the ladies got an itch to do something different.
I just made a list. What are things I love to do about all those? And then I Googled what's the best business in 2012, and food truck was on there. And I knew Tiffany was looking. And so I said, hey, what about a food truck? And she's like, yes.
So they launched the lunch bus in 2014 and have been cooking up a storm ever since.
We just started pairing what kind of sandwich we wanted, what kind of cheeses, or we'd find a cheese we liked and think, how could we make that into a sandwich? And it's turned out incredible.
Wisconsin master cheesemaker Chris Raleigh supplies the lunch bus with his Alpine-style cheese, Little Mountain, and he even has a namesake sandwich.
Oh, tell me a little bit about the lunch bus coming here. Is this a regular thing that happens? This
is the second time we've done it, and it was a big success the first time, and we're expecting that it should be something that we would do more often.
Grab a Raleigh Reuben, get some fresh cheese curds, and you're on your way.
Exactly.
Perfect
lunch.
We've got
everything to offer here, so.
Yes, you do.
We're happy to have them.
Your taste buds will be happy, too, if you plan to stop at their food truck. Just place your order and wait for the deliciousness to be delivered.
One Philly, made with love. Enjoy.
You're welcome.
One thing is for sure. If Wisconsin cheese is on your sandwich, you know it's made with pride and a little something extra. Whether your food is prepared on a cart or in a truck, if it's made with fresh local ingredients and Wisconsin cheeses, you know it's gonna be great.
Mariah?
Hello, oh my gosh, it looks so good. This has been the most delicious road trip ever. Next time you discover Wisconsin, make sure you look for one of our featured food trucks, or lunch bus in this case. You will not regret it.
This episode of Discover Wisconsin, America's Dairyland, is brought to you by the Dairy Farm Families of Wisconsin, the Wisconsin Milk Marketing Board. America's Dairyland is my land.
So are you hungry?
For more information and bonus video from this episode, go to discoverwisconsin.com. And don't forget, follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Discover Wisconsin Radio all across the state.
Hot, hot, hot. Oh. When it's burning your fingers, you put it in your mouth. That's what you do.